Hi there, and welcome to this video on Transactions zipForm Edition. Today, we'll be taking an overview of how a brokerage account works. Let's go ahead and get started. Today's focus will be two areas specific to brokerage accounts, the dashboard and the admin tab. This is the dashboard for a broker admin user account. It is very different from a regular agent account. It takes in information from all users within the brokerage account to populate graphs and tables. We'll go through each section and work our way down to the bottom. The All Offices drop-down menu in the top left allows you to filter the information in your dashboard by specific offices. This graph depicts transactions that have occurred during the current calendar month on the brokerage account across all users. The four tabs include New Listings, Closed Transactions, Expired Transactions, and Fell Through. The small graph icon next to each category is a link to the Run Report page. This page contains all the data that populates the graphs on the dashboard. You can cycle through the different reports by clicking on the drop-down menu. You can always return to the dashboard by clicking on Return to Dashboard. The Recent Activity feed shows actions taken by users on the brokerage account. This can range from creating transactions, submitting documents, sending forms for signature, and other actions. The Transactions to Approve box shows the number of transactions that users have sent for approval. Clicking on it will take you to a Run Report screen with more detailed information. This is also where you would access the Rapid Review function if you've opted to turn that feature on. The Documents to Approve box shows the number of documents that users have sent for approval. Clicking on it will take you to a Run Report screen with more detailed information. These task boxes show what tasks you have not started, in progress, and overdue. If you click on any of them, they will take you to the task area of the account. The Potential Sales Volume box will depict a graph with data relating to active listings and pending transactions that are currently active in the brokerage account. Both will have a Run Report link that you can click on for more detailed information. These three boxes will give you an indication of how many transactions are nearing the end of their life cycle. The top box shows the number of listing transactions expiring this calendar month. The middle box shows the number of purchase transactions with a closing date in this calendar month. The bottom box shows the number of transactions that are reaching the end of their retention period. These two graphs provide a breakdown of the different categories of transactions on the account. The top graph depicts the property types, for example, residential, industrial, or commercial, while the bottom graph depicts the transaction types, for example, purchases or leases. You can hover your mouse over the different parts to see more detailed information. The box with Google Maps allows you to see a visualization of where the properties are for the transactions on file. Click on Show Search to begin searching based on criteria you can select from. The Quarterly Performance area shows a breakdown of the closed transactions from each user on the account. It shows which office they're from, how many closed transactions they have, and the value of those transactions. The Account Info Summary is very handy for account management, as it gives you a breakdown of how many seats you have used and how many you have left. Users will show how many profiles are assigned and to what roles. Form Libraries will show what form libraries have been assigned. Products will show what products have been assigned. If you run out of seats for user profiles, form libraries, or products, we recommend you contact our sales team for further assistance. Now that we've covered the dashboard, let's move on to the admin tab. We're going to focus on the main areas within this tab, starting with reports. The report page is where the Run Report links in the dashboard take you. From here, you can cycle between reports by clicking on the drop-down menu, then select the data you want to see, the time frame if relevant, then Run Report. The user page shows the list of all users on a brokerage account. There is a color guide that indicates what roles each user has on the account. The New button in the top left allows you to create new user profiles. This page is covered in greater detail in another video regarding the roles in a brokerage account. The Office page shows the list of offices on the brokerage account. Like the User page, there's a New button to create a new office. To see the full office information, simply click on one. The Broker Settings page contains several tabs where you can determine the settings of the brokerage account for not only yourself, but all users. We're going to cover the main tabs in this page. Let's start with Permissions. This tab allows you to edit the permissions of all users on the account on basic tasks, such as being able to delete or edit items in a transaction. The Notifications tab gives you the option to receive a notification every time a specified event occurs. These include things like when a transaction status changes, a placeholder gets filled, or an e-signature packet is completed. The General area contains a few settings which can change the day-to-day layout and options for you and other users. The Compliance options can change the layout of how you can access and approve items. Transaction allows you to determine what transaction types are available for users to create transactions with. The Automation tab contains settings where events can be triggered automatically based on certain criteria. For example, you can set placeholders to automatically mark a document for review when filled. The Security tab contains additional security settings you can put in place. For example, you can enable two-factor authentication for agent user profiles when they sign into their accounts. That sums up this video on our overview of brokerage accounts for transactions zipForm edition. For more detailed information, we invite you to check out one of our webinars by clicking on the link in the description.